Hello there guys, WikiDoo here to give you another installment of the new Let's Play Team Fortress 2. And in this segment, we're going to be messing about with the guy who's pretty much lost his mind and has a fondness for fire. This here is the Pyro. Now, before I get into a discussion about the class, I figured I need to get this off my chest here first and foremost. Which is, I do not want to go into this segment having a very, like, overall negative tone to this, because Pyro in general always seems to be getting like a lot of flack for like some of the things like he can't like not do well, or like something how like he's like a new friendly sort of class and a lot of other stuff, like the things that he just cannot do well while other classes do better, and like, you know, like I don't want to go into this just being like a whiny little bitch and like, you know, something how like I was like 4 years ago. I mean, like, good God, being like my first segment of the old LP, starting off with Pyro, yeah, that's like not really a good thing. So really what I aim to do in this LP is to overall like introduce you guys to a class, present what options that it has, and then you go into the game yourself and then you form your own opinion, so to speak. I mean, yeah, there's my opinions, but don't really pay attention to them first and foremost. Something that I don't find useful, maybe something that might appeal to you, because, you know, different strokes for different folks, so to speak. So keep that in mind, is that I'm not going to be overall negative, although I will address some bad things that, you know, whether it be weapons or the class in general, is about here, but, you know, just keep that in mind. Okay, there's a sentry. Can you get that spy?
Alert. Our control.
Thought I saw our spy around here. Is he going to get it? Please. Well, it's around the corner, so I can at least do that. But the team already capped it, so I better back away. That's me just screwing around, I suppose. Alright, so let's talk about the defaults here. Starting off with the flamethrower. Flamethrower is a pretty good thing to start off with here. I mean, like, most defaults in a lot of classes have really good, like, defaults to run with. So in terms of the flamethrower here, it's pretty much right here in middle ground in terms of like damage. It's pretty much like best damage you can go for in general, and also having like good utility on the side. And I can't, and I'm stuck. Is he gonna chase after me? I don't think so. Although at least I'm pretty much golden to do an ambush. Is there one on the side? No, he's probably over on the far left. So let's try there. Ooh. I'm hearing a lot of trouble. I need to try to catch up and try to... Did he fall? Thought I saw a red person down there. I thought my team would be in trouble, but... You know, they had a good opportune moment to cap it, and I thought, you know, they would have. So yeah, a fair bit of damage and all the utility stuff. There's other weapons that either emphasize more on the damage or emphasize more on the utility aspect. So this here is pretty much like middle ground. If you want to switch in between doing ambushes and then switch to utility, this one's not a bad choice. And shotgun, this is pretty much going to be your most reliable sidearm most of the time, since it's your, like, most... I think it's like your only, like, hit-scan weapon that you have available. Oh, well, actually, there is the reserve shooter. He does have that, but, you know, it's essentially the same thing like the shotgun. Where'd you go? Yeah, let's gain some points and put you out. Yay! But yeah, good for a lot of situations. I mean, good against, like, other pyros, too, actually. Because, you know, you're already, like, doing play damage to the other one. They won't be set on fire, so it's best, you know, like, pelt them with, shotgun shots. And if they're out of the range of your flamethrower, you know, that's what this comes in, you know? You know, like that sniper. Although I shot him, but he was still able to land the headshot. And they're gonna cap the point. However, I'm just gonna go around. Whee. And the other thing that he has is the fire axe. Although, you're pretty much never going to use it, because literally, like, all of his melee options are better than the default. Like, freaking third degree is at least better. Because it only has like one stat to go with it. And that's all there is. Alright, so now I talk about defaults, let's get right into like some of the things that like the Pyro and like some of the issues that people often talk about. Where are my fucks, God? I don't know. You left it on the corner of Walnut Street or something. Random street name, go, I don't know. So anyway, the issues about the Pyro I'll have to address. First off, his ability to do ambushes. Now, when the Pyro does execute the ambush, it's... I wouldn't lie, it's okay. I don't mind, like, if he does the ambush stuff. I mean, his flames can be fairly damaging, and also the flames itself can be, like, disorientating or at least annoying to some people. However, the issue lies with him doing ambushes is trying to set himself up to do the ambush. Because pretty much as far as I know, he only has like two weapons that could help him assist to do the ambushes, which is the use of his power jack for movement and his detonator to do flare jumps. So he does have some sort of options to do those things. And this is where it gets to the argument where like classes can do other things better. Like the scout being able to have him using his movement speed and double jump to get him to certain places that no other classes could. Same thing goes for Soldier and Demo with the use of their like explosives to like get like height advantage and all that stuff. Did we cap that? Okay, yeah, we did. And there's also Spy with the use of his cloak, so they're able to like set themselves up a lot easier with doing ambushes. Pyro, all he has is to his name is just like map knowledge and just running there most of the time. So if he's going to be like categorized as an ambush class, there has to be like some sort of like options for him to do so. And most, like I said, I can think of his power jack and detonator. Oh, nothing like a sandwich in the middle of battle. Ain't that right? Okay. So yeah, there's this ambush thing, and another one has to do with his damage output in general. Now, don't get me wrong, I mean like, you know, he has like the fire damage stuff, he has the damage over time sort of thing, the afterburn sort of stuff. That's all fine. I mean, when you get someone in point blank range, continuously, it does like 150 damage per second. Like I said, if you get all the fire particles on the enemy. However, to put that into perspective, the heavy, who's more efficient at close range, does 520 damage per second, which is like more than triple. And Engineer wasn't managing that apparently. Although he probably was, but just not efficiently. That would put you out. Oh dear. Yeah, that's something that Pyro did that I will not do. Just attack heavy head on. Bleh. Here, we'll go around this way. Victory. Or a scout's gonna backcap it. That works too. 42. That was mostly just doing a whole lot of like air blasting. That's the majority of my points right there. What can I say? I'm an air blasting hoe or something. I don't know what's wrong with me. So yeah, when you put that into perspective, the heavy is a lot more efficient when it comes to like doing damage output when in close quarters. People run away the heavy from the heavy for a good reason. You, on the other hand, is just like, it's basically less and all that stuff. Disable team unbalancing? We'll keep it on. If pressing no, what it does is to keep auto balancing, then yeah. What else to talk about? Oh yeah, his ability to do like afterburn. Now, when you think about the numbers with the afterburn here, if you set someone ablaze and not do anything for a while, it lasts for only 10 seconds. But in terms of damage during 10 seconds, it's like a total of 60 damage. So when you think about it, when you put someone on flame that's a lighter class, like a scout, it pretty much reduces them to almost half health. However, the unfortunate thing about the afterburn, since, you know, fire is very readily available to the Pyro class, a whole lot of other classes have some sort of mechanic to, like, disable the flames to some degree. Ow. What was that? Oh look, Neon Annihilator, which, if there was water on this map, I would do that, but no, I wouldn't. No way, no how. But yeah. So yeah, like, other classes have, like, some sort of mechanic to disable the afterburn. Like, Scout has the Mad Milk, Snapper has Jurati. The Demo has, like, afterburn immunity with the use of his shield, and also less damage from fire in general. Medic with his natural health regen to cancel some of the afterburn. Actually, fun tidbit is that if you were using the Degreaser and use that on the Medic, his health regen will just flat out negate. Oh my god. Yeah, use this one in doubt. Nah, you're no fun. So yeah, there's like a lot of things that other classes can do against him with, like, you know, like afterburn and all that stuff. And of course, another thing to understand is, like, is there like some sort of skill related to this class at all? Because, like, I'm not entirely familiar with the history of the Pyro, but I think what I found out is that, like, he was, like, pretty weak when he first started out, and then, like, there was all these, like, these damage buffs over these years and all that stuff in order to, like, actually, you know, make himself on par to what he's considered to be the offensive class, because he's officially labeled as an offensive class within the game menu. So they're trying to do that. Even though most of the time I'm using him for utility, so that's kind of weird when you think it that way. And I can't really set myself up to do something here. Because the guy that pretty much in lockdown. Okay, let's try to take the low road. Let's go around this way. Pray nobody takes this path. Oh, here we go. Yeah, like, as soon as, like, he notices me, I just puff and I'm just, you know, so he doesn't get me as much. Whoa. Something happened with my aim there. I didn't mean to look up that way. So yeah, like, with that, over the years, it's kind of, like, been buffed in some sort of way. Just try to make him more viable in some way. And it's, like very noob-friendly in terms of that, because it's, like, easy to aim sort of stuff. Just, like, flame and forget sort of deal. And just because of the easiness that this class has, it's, like, you know, like, there's, like, no skill involved with this when you compare things just to other classes like Sniper, which is, like, more aim-dependent and such. All you do is you just do the flame and forget sort of deal. There are some people might say, like, there is some sort of skill involved. I mean, the only noticeable thing that the Pyro does have in terms of some skill is with the use of his compression blast, having to, like, reflect projectiles back at other enemies. But most of the time, it's just anticipating the rocket or whatever, whatnot to come at you and all that stuff. It all comes down to anticipation, which you think of it what you will, if that's a skill or not. There, good show there, Spy. Yeah, I figured I'd wait for him to do the kill, and then I just walk right in. Good stuff. He's just right out of my range. Dang it. He's just a freaking Gibbous Scout. That one free man, he's not free to fly no more, because he had that soda popper. Uh-oh. I really make use of a lot of my shotgun, what can I say? So yeah, whatever he has, like, skill or not, it's questionable. But, you know, so besides all of those kind of downsides that I've kind of mentioned, like, what goes against him, I can only go this way. Yay, I'm going right behind lines. Like, I'm kind of like a spy, except, you know, I'm cheesing my way through maps and such. And he's wise. Dang it! Getting chased everywhere. Yeah, there we go. For the most part, that scout was being wise and staying out of my range. And I'm having a hard time, really. But, you know, once he gets lit on fire, you know, that afterburn just wills him down quite easily, being the light class and all. But anyway, besides all of those, like, negative points that I've mentioned here, there's pretty much, like, one other thing that I left out from my last LP. Or, like, for, like, all, maybe for, like, all classes in general. And that is just the good old-fashioned fun factor. I mean, like, overall, when you want to play the class, you need to have fun, don't you? I mean, this is kind of like the class where it's, like, you know, easy to go about and just, like, you know, like I said, mess about with, like, a lot of things. You know, people like the concept of just, like, burning enemies anyway and all that stuff, and he wants to trade with me. I don't know what I have to offer, but, no, I'm busy. But yeah, there's like fun factor. I mean, you know, like having to like go ahead and just all that stuff. It's just like a lazy man's class. What can you say? You know, it's just like easy stuff, lounge around, you know, just doing something like stuff. Honestly, really, I do not mind playing this class. That's all I can say. I mean, despite me trying to be like, you know, like talking about negative points, I seriously don't mind playing this. I mean, there's still some sort of weirdness to play it, despite, you know, like, him being, like, hit and miss with what he can do. And he's managing to, like, dodge my bullets. But my fire, no sir. Ooh. Beggar's bazooka? Beggar's bazooka. This'll be a fun challenge to reflect. Or not. But yeah, really, that's all I could say about certain, like, discussion topics with the Pyro here, so that's all I can say. Oh, Jesus. Alright, cool. Alright, can we go ahead and see about, like, capping?
Alert. The control point is being captured.
No, they're being aware right now. Yeah, that's the downside. Once they see you, you can't set up for an ambush. That's the other thing. What class can do that better? The spy. You know, whatevs. Here, let me go ahead and catch this Pyro.
Victory.
Okay, we won this anyway. Yay! Alright, that gives me an excuse to swap out to actually try some weapons now. Sorry, let's go ahead and take a look at this loadout now. If it will let me switch. Is it gonna let me do that? Apparently not. I'm apparently having issues. That's not a good sign. Alrighty guys, I'm back. Sorry about that. We had a bit of an issue with the item server being shut down, so I had to wait like a few couple minutes to see if it will come back up, so. And we're no longer on the previous map, which is Yukon, so we've only been in there for like about like 18 minutes, so I figured we go ahead and switch up to another map. We might even get to a third map if we're lucky. So anyway, this here is Steel. This one is a different sort of like control point map right here. As me and this mech try to get through the gate slowly. What's going on here? That's what's going on. Alright, we'll go ahead and cap this. So anyway, we're on Steel. Now this map's different in terms of capturing control points because you can go in sequential order by capping through A, B, C, D, and then E, or you can just go and flat out go and try to capture the last point right up there. Although it's very, very slow to capture the last point, so it's kind of a weird design here, but at least they're trying to differentiate that just a little bit. Ah, damn it. I walked right into that. So anyway, we can go ahead and talk about some unlocks here. So this here is the back burner. And this one has quite a bit of a history right off the bat, because back when the Pyro update came out, which I wasn't there for, by the way, so I don't know much, but I heard that there was like a health bonus when it first came out, which only lasted for a little bit until they just removed it. And that health bonus, was there just so that, you know, that Pyros can be more viable in terms of doing like ambush stuff. And also it didn't have the compression blast back then. Which on the same update of like the Pyro update sort of deal, they added the compression blast to the default, so having the ability to like do stuff. I think like, I'm not sure what came in what order, having to like, how to like deflect like projectiles, or like when they were able to like extinguish them or puff like players away from you or something. All that sort of stuff. Well, there was proper use of that back burner. And back then, this used to have been the WMS1 sort of weapon, just because, you know, it had no air blast. There's a lot of weird things going on. Air Heavy, take care of that, please. Thank you. I'll try to block them off as they cap. Okay. And we'll just go ahead and crowd all this over here. Yeah, that was good grammar there. No! You knew who's gonna be. Okay, enough about the history. What it actually does is that if you hit somebody in the back with it, it does a full, flat-out crit. But now they made a change. They changed it so that you can actually, you know, do an air blast at least. Although, like I said, the utility comes at a cost. Where, God damn it. What? I switched to defense! What asinine thing is this? God damn it. That's like the worst feeling ever. Having to suddenly switch to the losing team right at the last minute. Well, I guess I was born to do is do WMS1, right? Because, you know, I gotta get him off the point somehow. Meh. Waluigi time! Meh. That's my WMS1 call. I'm Waluigi all of a sudden. God, one health. That's ridiculous. So yeah, it comes more at the cost to do the air blast here. So you have to be very selective with doing your air blast. You can prioritize, like, pretty much... Oh, shit. Got that headshot. God, my nemesis and all that shit. Blah, blah, blah. Anyway. So yeah, because of the increased costs, I don't really roll with it. Anyways. Like I said, you have to be selective when you have to do air blasts in dire situations, like to put out the flames for your medic, or, you know, having to block an Uber even. Some of the more, like, important things to, like, use your compression blast for. And the other one here is the flare gun. Flare gun is another one of those sidearms here. Not really useful on the level of, like, frickin'... Ah, damn it. Well, at least he's burning now. I kind of, like, stood in a straight line for him to do that anyway. What the hell? Suddenly a scout. No, I needed that! This is probably going to be risky, but I'm going to go around this way. And I'd be right. He actually reflected that... What the fuck? Damn it. He decided to reflect that flare gun shot for some reason. Actually, let's go ahead and probably, like, switch it out of this eventually. I guess we'll roll with this a little bit here. Anyway, flare gun, when somebody is currently on flames and you hit somebody with it, it'll deal a full crit, you know. This is like the Pyro's, like, solution having to do, like, long-range flaming stuff. Since, of course, you know, it's troublesome having to get in close quarters to set somebody on fire. You know, like with the case of that heavy, if I went forward, I probably would have died. Ah, damn it. Oh, did I hit him? Or was it the guy up in the balcony? Well, I don't know. Okay, there's a spy. Maybe I can help him out somehow. I'll just have to... Gotta lure somebody over here. And I would have shown that off if he hadn't died to the stickies. Now this Pyro is going to be a pain in the ass since he has the shotgun. But there's your long-range options for flare guns. Flare guns, for the most part, is can be a decent sidearm to use.